Class 6, Chapter 9, The Living Organisms and Their Surroundings. The living organisms they need place to live, and this is known as habitat. So habitat, the surrounding where organisms live, and they all depend on the habitat for food and shelter. Now when they live in some habitat, they adapt to it and they form different features which help them to adapt to the habitat. The presence of specific features for certain habits which enable a plant or an animal to live in its surrounding is called adaptation. So these are required so that they can survive in that habitat. According to the habitat, we can divide all the animals in two categories, that is terrestrial and aquatic. Terrestrial animals and plants are those which live on land. Aquatic animals and plants are those which live on water. And according to this, we can divide the habitat again in two parts, that is biotic and abiotic components. So we have biotic and abiotic components of all the habitats. So biotic components involves the living things such as plants and animals. Abiotic component, it has rocks, soil, air and water, which are non-living things. Now we have adaptations in different animals according to the habitat in which they are living. Now let's see adaptation in desert and mountain plants. Desert plants, they use very less water through transpiration. The leaves in the desert plants are either absent or very small, or they are present in the shape of spines. This helps in reducing loss of water from leaves through transpiration. Because water is less in desert. Now mountain plants, these are normally cone shaped and have sloping branches. The leaves of some of these trees are little like. This helps the rainwater and snow to slide down. Now let's see adaptation in animals. Mountain animals, animals living in the mountains are also adapted to the conditions. They have thick fur to survive the cold winters. For example, snow, leopard and yak, they have fur on their body. Now grassland animals, a lion is a strong animal which hunts its prey. The deer has its eyes on sides of his head to see around of him if there is any predator. The animal has its eyes on the front to see its prey clearly. So these are all the adaptations which help him in surviving. Now let's see adaptation in aquatic plants and animals. Aquatic animals, most of the aquatic animals mainly have gills and streamlined body. But some animals don't have gills like whale and dolphins. They have to come out to the surface of the sea to breathe. They breathe through nostril or blow holes. Aquatic plants, some of these plants have their stem connected to soil below the water. Roots in aquatic plants are reduced in size as their main function is to hold the plant in place. Now all the living organisms, they show some common characteristics. For example, all living things, they need food to survive. They show growth. So plants also, they show growth. Animals also, they show growth. And they all respire. They respond to the stimuli. Respond to stimuli means when we are exposed to some external, response or stimuli, then all animals they responded. For example, suppose animals they touch the hot things, so they simply remove their hands or their body from the hot object. Now how do plants respond to the stimuli? You all know the plant touch me not. If you touch the leaves of the plants, all the leaves they come together, and in this way they respond, and after some time all the leaves they just open up. So in this way the plants also they respond to the stimuli. Then all the living beings they means all the wastage is removed from the body through excretion. They reproduce their own kind. So this is also very important so that the species of the plants can be carried on. Then all the living organisms, they show movement. So all these are all the characteristics of the living.